Very good afternoon to respected jury members, respected professors, associate professors, assistant professors, and my dear students. Today's topic for presentation, I'm sorry to say, I am myself Dr. Azim Manzoor Bhatt. I'm working as an assistant professor and in charge head, Department of Forensic Medicine and Toxicology, Gauravan Medical College, Anantnag, Jammu and Kashmir. Today's topic of presentation is pattern of intracranial hemorrhages in cases of two-wheelers without wearing helmets in fatal road traffic accidents in Mangalore. Next slide, please. Births and deaths are the two extremes of life, and death is the ultimate truth. But unnatural death is known for its immense striking power and is always a surprise. Death due to road traffic accidents are one of the common forms of unnatural death and its history as old as invention of the wheel. The head and the other organs were injured leads to the fatal involving blunt trauma, which may be accidental, suicidal, or homicidal. Road traffic accidents is the third major preventable cause of death. Next slide, please. In many countries, roads are planned and built to allow the motor vehicles to travel faster, while insufficient thought is given to the need of two-wheelers and pedestrians. Two-wheeler riders are more vulnerable to the RTA for sustaining injuries. This group of road users do not have a protective shell around them and therefore are more of the risk than those inside vehicles. They are at additional risk when their need has not been taken into consideration during the planning of roads and construction. The present study was undertaken to compare the injury pattern in drivers and pillion riders in two-wheelers with accidents. The aims and objectives of this study is to study the pattern of intracranial hemorrhages in case of two-wheelers without wearing helmets in fatal road traffic accidents in Mangalore. Next slide, please. Material and methods. The present record-based retrospective study was... One second, please. It was conducted at the Wenlock District Hospital and Justice K.S. Hegde Hospital, Mangalore. All the cases of road traffic accidents involving fatal head injuries, which underwent autopsy at the Wenlock District Hospital and Justice K.S. Hegde Hospital, Mangalore, from January 2009 to December 2013 were included in the study. Out of these cases, patients involved in two-wheeler accidents were further evaluated, while all other fatal injuries other than the road accidents were excluded. A pro forma was prepared accordingly to collect the data based on the disease particulars with complete external and internal examinations in respect to studies of those involved in fatal head injury cases due to road traffic accidents. A record detailed, including the name, age, sex, address, and the information furnished by the police in the inquest papers, postmortem reports, investigating reports, if any, and the cause of death has to be registered in that record. All the data obtained was kept anonymous to protect the identity of the deceased and for the confidential medico-legal information. The details about the pattern of entered in the pro forma. Data from all the pro forma was compiled in a master chart, analyzed by calculating sum, range, and distribution, and the percentage. The data was also tabulated and appropriate inferences were drawn. These inferences were compared with the other similar studies. Next slide, please. Next slide. Results. Out of total 101 cases of RTA with two-wheelers, 91.09% has not used helmets, while only 8.91% were wearing the helmets. Majority of the cases not using helmets were in the age group of 20 to 30 years of age. Among helmet non-users, 94.57% were males. Among this, diffuse extravasation of the blood from scalp was observed in 41.3% of the cases and followed by the combined extravasation from the frontal, parietal, and temporal region, which is 14.13% among non-helmet users. Next slide, please. Abrasion was seen in 71.75% and laceration in 70.66% were the most common injuries to the face and head. Subarachnoid hemorrhage was seen in 83.7% of the people, was the most common of the intracranial hemorrhages, followed by the subdural hemorrhage, which is 70.65%. Contusion was seen in 32.61%, followed by the brain injury among non-helmet users with edema of the brain, which is seen in 27.17% of the cases. There was no brain injury diagnosed in 26.09% of the cases. Among the non-helmet users, victims with a diffuse brain injury was seen in 30.43% of the cases, where the frontal lobe was involved in 26.9% of the cases. Next slide, please. So it was in the discussion, it was observed that out of 101 cases of RTA with two-wheelers, 91.0% has not used helmets, while the others 8.91% were wearing the helmets. And the majority of the cases was not using the helmets. And they were in the age group of 20 to 30 years, followed by 30 to 40 years of the case. Similar studies were also conducted by the Manoj Tripathi et al., Mumtaz B. et al. These was found the similar studies. Among non-helmet users, 94.57% cases were males, while among helmet users, all were males. Similarly, Manoj Tripathi and others have observed the similar results. In the present study, subarachnoid hemorrhage was present in 83.7% of the cases, which was the commonest intracranial hemorrhages, followed by the subdural hemorrhage, which was also observed by the R. Ravi Kumar in his study, which has followed subdural hemorrhage in 90.83% of the cases, which is the commonest intracranial hemorrhages, followed by the subarachnoid hemorrhage. It was found in 70.53% of the cases. Next slide, please. Conclusion of the study is subarachnoid hemorrhages and subdural hemorrhages was the commonest intracranial hemorrhages in cases of two-wheelers without wearing helmets in fatal road traffic accidents in Mangalore. And brain contusion and edema was observed in majority of the cases. And there are 26.9% of the cases where there was no brain injury diagnosed. And next slide, please. These are my references, sir. Thank you.